Ladies and gentlemen, the issue of media freedom in Europe is not only fundamental in the overall struggle to preserve democratic freedoms in our continent, but also one that deeply concerned me, as I myself am a journalist. Indeed, I have had a personal experience of what suppression of media freedom feels like, as I vividly recall the abrupt, violent closure of the Greek public broadcaster in 2013, an event that many members of this assembly must also remember. For the past 2 years, the current Greek government of the left has been engaged in a continuous struggle to introduce fairness, ensure transparency, and install legal order upon a formerly lawless and unregulated media landscape that provided fertile ground for corruption and all sorts of opaque and unwarranted links between private media owners, financial interests, and political parties. This is all reflected on the report of the ad hoc committee set up by the Hellenic Parliament precisely in order to investigate those links, a report which is the product of several months of open debate and public examination of evidence. In this struggle, the Hellenic Republic is showing in practice its respect for the rule of law, especially in the process of granting of television broadcasting license for the very first time since, for the past 27 years, no private TV broadcaster in Greece operated legally, something that might come as a surprise to many members of this assembly, but it's however true. Yes, media freedom is absolutely essential for democracy in Europe. And media freedom means free press, freedom to express opinions and engage in dialogue and freedom to seek out and expose the truth. However, I must point on that this assembly will unfortunately not be holding a debate during this session on the country where media freedom is perhaps most threatened, where journalists are most under attack, and where Article 10 of the ECHR is most violated today, Turkey. This fact alone is deplorable and goes against the principles of the Council. Despite the fact that Turkey is mentioned in the report, not holding an urgent debate on the situation, there is a bad signal for the reliability, the credibility, and the effectiveness of organization, and one that needs to be corrected urgently. Media freedom, free press, and the freedom of thought and expression are among the pillars of our common European legal culture. It is paramount importance that today, in an age when these pillars are facing new threats and new challenges, we remain true to the founding principles of the Council of Europe. Thank you.